Then yet a very important question to be able to address here is, what to do if someone else has already said what I wanted to say in a group discussion? So now in this kind of a situation, my friends, you have two choices to make. One choice is that if you really do not have enough content at that point in time, make sure that you are able to expand on the same topic by giving it a broader spectrum to be able to see a new perspective on the same point if you think you're able to do that. And if not, then drop absolutely the point and talk about some fresh points. What happens usually is that if you wait too long in a group discussion, chances are very, very bleak that the same points may have not probably been repeated by the others in the group discussion. So make sure that if you have a chunk of thing that you need to speak about, space them out and say out the most important and the most popular ones right in the beginning to avoid them getting duplicated by the others in the group. Another question is it okay for me if I use a slang? Of course not. Never use a slang, because there isn't a slightest approach that you should follow where you may probably seem out that you are looking very, very casual at any point in time. So do not use a slang. Another thing that you would want to clarify is, can I use another language other than the English language if I need to make up my point? So my friends, the answer is no. I'm really sorry, in a group discussion, please stick to the English language. You may want to use it as much as you want, but later on you may want to express that to the panel of experts, but please restrict yourselves from using any other language at that point in time. A very important question to address here is that how is aggression measured and looked at in a group discussion? So my friends, it's a very, very important thing to note for you. The moment you are strongly reacting or becoming negative about another line of thoughts from another participant, that's looked at as being aggressive rather than being assertive. And how strong is a reaction on listening to the other participants and how do you react is the measure of your aggressiveness. So make sure that the very mantra of a group discussion is stay calm, stay confident and keep your emotions completely under control. So you may want to ask at this point in time, then what level of aggression is seen as acceptable? So of course, there is no level that we can talk about of aggression which is seen acceptable. What is seen acceptable is assertiveness. So if you need to make up a strong point against a participant's viewpoints that they're sharing across, always start on with a statement which may say that I wish I could have agreed on to the point that you've discussed, but I would like to differ on these points as A, B, C and D. So this is the way so that you're able to politely be assertive and talk about the point that you would like to discuss. The next very important question is, what is the level of accuracy which is required in the facts and figures that you must quote? So any guesses for that? Chances are very bleak that you will be able to or allowed to speak about any facts and figures which are not true, but there are only about 5% chances that you will probably be allowed to quote up the facts and figures which may not really wither or differ from it very, very substantially. So make sure if you're quoting the facts and figures, they're absolutely authentic and true. So now the very important question to address here is that motivating other people to speak up, to be able to showcase our ability of leadership and qualities and ability to be able to lead, is it looked upon favorably by the panel of members? So my friends, it completely depends, and the answer lies in understanding that if you probably might just be throwing across in the group in the open and asking for them for the suggestions, and if anybody would like to contribute, that might probably put you in an awkward situation, because the panel of members may not probably think it's a very favorable thing for you to do. But in other situations where let's say one of the participants who's been able to contribute at this point in time and is not being able to expand his views, you could definitely help that participant by expanding their views and thereby motivating him to speak. So you may want to ask at this stage that, can I be a little aggressive with a lady participant? So my friends, of course, you need to be respectful to each and every single participant. It's not about the gender, whether it's a man or a woman, but please make sure that you adhere to the rules of politeness in a group discussion.